Hello everyone, welcome. My name is alphaWOLFIE, and I'm showing you my Wii U collection. So this is the Wii U GamePad and the console in my room, of course. And I'm just going to show you basically my collection so far. Any additions I might add to it, but for the main part, I think I've got what I want for my Wii U collection. So starting off, I have Super Mario 3D World. So a brand new world filled with Mario fun. Run, jump and climb for all kinds of exciting new levels, solo or with friends. Up to 4 players can work together. Peach joins the fun. Pick up 4 characters, each with unique skills. Peach glides through the air. Mario, balanced all-rounder. Luigi leaps to great heights. And Toad dashes at high speed. Also, there is a sort of leaf guide which help for beginners. If a challenge is giving you too much trouble, use the item will appear with the sort of kind of cut leaf shape. Offline 1-4 players required the Nintendo Wii U pad, compatible with the Wii U stick and Nunchuk type things, or the controller, or the Nunchuk and the advanced Wii U controller. So this is a really awesome game, probably going to be in everyone's collection, no doubt about it, so I really don't have to really go on about it. I can show you just a little bit inside. So there we go. And as you can tell, the characters, the main theme is where Mario and all the other characters can dress up as inside a cat costume, and that's part of the game. So that's Super Mario 3D World, and this is definitely a very good collection. It has to be in everyone's collection, put it that way. My next one is another Mario game and very renowned, and that is Mario Kart 8. And I do apologize about the lighting, but hopefully it's okay. I mean, it's quite shiny in the back distance. No, it's working. Anyway, up the walls, across ceilings, race without limits. That's all it says, and then the rest of it's in languages. New. Weapon wise, boomerang flower, super horn, and piranha plant can be used with the Wii U pad, the Wii U stick with the racing wheel, that's an additional attachment called the Wii Wheel, sold separately. It also has a Mario Kart TV, where basically you can see your end result game replay and push it onto whatever they call it, the sort of live TV, and watch others and all that stuff. So steering uses standard or motion controllers. Share your highlight videos. Online matches with up to 12 players. Offline 1-4 players. Online 2-12 players. Like I said, it's compatible with the Wii U pad, also the Nunchuk and motion controller, also with the Wii U controller, or the stick and the advanced controller, or the steering wheel. Basically, your vehicles can sort of glide and do sort of corkscrews and go up verticals and all that stuff, and you're throwing all types of weapons and stuff. I really don't need to sort of basically go on about it, but it's one of those big franchises. Also, I think you can fly, you can use motorbikes, they have different attachments like different wheels, different carts. The tracks are fun, bright, colorful, adding some old ones and new ones. There was a downloadable content which you do have to pay for. It gives you additional tracks, which are all good. So that's the game there, as you can see, and that's the sort of back. So like I said, I do apologize about the lighting, but there we go. So that's Mario Kart 8. Moving on, another kind of Mario, but sort of everyone in it, which is Mario Party 10. Party with 5 players or even your amiibo. Bowser Party, up to 5 players can take part in a showdown between Bowser and Team Mario. On the D-pad, if you're Bowser, you can play as him to take down Team Mario. Versus Mario, Team Mario head for the goal while fleeting Bowser. It's a very sort of interesting sort of game. Basically, one person gets to play as Bowser and tries to eliminate all the other characters on screen. Mario Party compete in mini games to win mini stars. The player with the most wins, feature field boards, and boss battles. Amiibo Party requires the amiibos, power up the tokens, and change the board. Amiibo are used as counters and can you put your tokens to good use. So you get to have a theme board, which is just a little mini board, and it takes into like four quarters. So if you have a Luigi, one section will be a sort of a Luigi themed, and if you have Yoshi, you have Yoshi's little theme, and all the other sort of amiibos types of characters will change parts of the board to their sort of iconic status. So like Mario will have some things like sort of pipes and tubes and things like that. More than 70 new mini games, paintball battle, splash your rivals, flash forward, pose for the camera, stampede stats, which are more of dual drop, a solo game challenge, so basically offline 1 to 5 players. Requires the Wii U pad and the motion controller stick. A sensor bar is required to use the Wii Remote or Wii Remote Plus with this software. Also compatible with the amiibos themselves, such as Mario, Luigi, Peach, Yoshi, Toad, Bowser, Donkey Kong, Rosalina, and Wario. So that's the inside. Okay, and that's the back. Yes, don't worry about the code, it's all downloaded, so you can't use it. So there you go. It's an okay game, but it's not the best. They could have done a lot better. There were some interesting ideas, but slightly poor execution. I'm sure that most people would say the other Mario Party games were slightly better, but this is okay, that's all. Which is a shame, because you want to shout and wave around and say, yeah, this is Mario Party 10, but it's like, there's some things which, it just feels some parts are unbalanced, kind of luck of the win of the draw, and sometimes the fact that you're all together in one sweep, so you don't move in separate parts, you sort of move all together. So it's, if say like it's your turn and you got a 2 and you move 2, all the other characters move 2, and then you go into that battle and see if you win. So it's kind of, there's some parts of that which are a bit weird, but there we go. You can go onto YouTube and search that up. I'm just showing you my collection. Next one is obviously Super Smash Bros. Wii U. Up to 8 players, the biggest ever Nintendo Smash Up. Includes a few special guests like Pac-Man, Mega Man, Sonic, etc. All new modes, Smash Tour. Customize any fighter to your liking and personalize your Mii. Select special moves and more to fine-tune your fighter skills. You can also connect to the Nintendo 3DS version, use it as a controller, transfer customized fighters between the different versions of the game. Requires a copy of Super Smash Bros. For the Nintendo 3DS. Also, amiibo characters compatible amiibo figures can appear in game as friends or foes. Offline 1-8 players, online 2-4 players required. The Wii U pad, of course, Nunchuk and stick compatible, motion controllers, the Wii U controller or the stick and the controller, or the GameCube controller, also an SD card if you need to. Amiibo features, play with your amiibos in battles as rivals and partners, level up and customize your amiibo. So basically you can add your amiibo and it reacts to like a training amiibo, so the more you fight it the more it gets powerful and so on. It's kind of skew-iffy, it's a little bit redundant, but it's there for your sort of enjoyment. You can use battle against other friends with their amiibos and see how well they've trained their amiibos. But it's not necessary, but there we go. So basically, there we go, that's the disc. So about the lighting that I said again. And that's the back. Okay, so that's that. It is a very good game. Definitely in your collection as well. Does it move on from the other Super Smash Brothers? That's an interesting one. I'll leave that to your thoughts. But it's a good game for your collection. And last one. And that's Captain Toad Treasure Tracker. So set off on a treasure tracking Toad adventure. Over 70 charmingly compact courses. Explore using the Wii U GamePad, touchscreen and motion controls. Viewing courses from different angles may reveal the route to treasure. Look around using the GamePad. I'll try and explain that in a moment, but Captain Toad's moves, he may not be able to jump, but he's got a few trademark tricks for getting out of scraps, so such as plucking out plants, chucking out vegetables, fruits, stuff, smashing with a pickaxe, and riding on a minecart. Also, track as Toadette 2, female version. Offline one player. Requires the Wii U pad. So basically it's like a little puzzle element. It's kind of like a game board type, but in a sort of a 3D world, and you can move it all around stuff, things like that. And there's a little sections like mine carts and all that things, and sort of little boss battles, and basically collecting as much coins and moving objects around, digging, plucking. It's a whole sort of adventure puzzle type feel to it, and using the Wii pad to sort of move around and find different angles, because you've got, don't just initially just see it as the front bit, you can move it around and around and around and find different angles to these levels. This is actually very enjoyable. You probably could get through it quite a bit, but replayability is a little bit there, because you got levels which you have to do certain tasks and come back to it. There's a whole addition to this, and it's just pleasant fun. Definitely worthy in your collection as well. I'm going to say all these worthy in collections because I got them, so I'm a bit biased, but it's charming and a little taxing places, but not too hard. You will miss a few items, but that can always, you can come back to it and have that replayability and try harder, like sort of time missions and collecting things that you didn't see before, and so on. So that's my first collection. So if you want to see more, stay tuned for more videos. Until then, take care and thank you for watching. Bye!